Good morning. It's George Lees again. Back indoors. Yeah, in my cowboy hat. That is one of the BBC directors that is on one of the biggest boardrooms that I've ever found in the whole of my life. His name is Williams, I think, from Wales. We'll see him later on as I give you all of the mugshots and the covers for the wife of this man. Yeah, who's also on the board.
4 years in jail for Jeffrey Archer, the liar and the cheat. His last minutes of freedom today on his way to face the jury at the Old Bailey. Tonight he's in prison. Lawyers say he'll appeal against the convictions. Good evening. Jeffrey Archer, the millionaire novelist and former top conservative, is preparing to spend his first night in prison. He started a 4-year sentence for lying and cheating. A jury...
All politicians are immune to those crimes, okay? Sorry, not immune to those crimes. They have immunity from them. The keyword is millionaire, which is now billionaire. And this takes us to Scottish treason as well. That is David Steele of Akewood, yeah, who was my local MP for Roxburgh, Selkirkshire and Peebles through all of my time as a boy. Yeah, he's a massive mobster. That is him with the Kevin Drummond in the sheriffdom celebrating the Rothschilds Three Arrows project for the Borders region with the same logo on his lapel as every copper in our country. Yeah, in the coppers in Lord Hollick's region of our country actually wear, let me put the camera down for a second till I get you Lord Hollick. Yeah, up for grabs. He is a massive money launderer. I've made videos with John Patterson on him, and he is the man that shares the jokes about the know-nothings of Notting Hill. He makes the Notting Hill film, yeah, as if he is not in that region laundering money out of Finchley Road, and all of it is massive. They appear, all of them, in the House of Lords pretending that they're fixing things. Let me show you that. Okay, so Jeffrey Archer's missus is on these boards, and there's images of John Patterson's new friend Ian Hislop with the word Piso in his name, and all of the news that comes out about the trivia that Jeffrey Archer and his lovers are involved in. Yeah, the billionaire word is the key to this video, and the number of directors that they have on the ITV boards is absolutely massive. Over 1800. It takes you about 45 minutes to load them up onto the computer, which is why I've taken a series of stills of David Steele the crook, yeah, who's on these boards, yeah, running every local news event as their directors and with the money stream that accompanies that. Okay, so here is Jeffrey Archer. House of Lords Economic Affairs Committee has been investigating the economics of High Speed Rail 2. This is the only thing, apart from my videos, that you can find for Lord Hollick of Notting Hill.
Affairs Committee that's been looking at HS2. Have the government made the economic case for the line?
We think not, not yet. The committee is very much in favour of investment in rail infrastructure, and the two issues that the government is seeking to solve is one a capacity issue and the other one rebalancing growth in the UK economy. We think on both cases the evidence we receive so far does not suggest that the case has been properly made for what is less than £50 billion for many years.
One of the government's main arguments for HS2 is it will address long-term overcrowding, particularly on the West Coast Main Line. How big of a problem is that?
You remember that one? That's Branson's contract. So this is a massive cabal of newsmen and corrupted directors, and there is what I've got on Eleanor Kate Irvine's massive boards. Yeah, she's the one that is doing most of the administrative chores for this massive cabal, but each one of them has a separate strand. There's Wow Hollick of Notting Hill, And wow, Buck and Bland links to Notting Hill. Wow, Notting Hill itself. And you can guess who the commanders in chief are again. Yeah, I think. Yeah, but Eleanor Kate Irvin, I'm going to take you now to her boards, and that is all of the massive uprooting of our tracks and all of the funding of new railways all across our world since the 1950s, when they were able to dismember everybody, our massive infrastructural network across all of British Rail. And all of British Rail then belonged to the Britons. Yeah, all of it now carved up. And I've got the members of the Centrica boards. Let me just give you some key names. Heather Rabatz, that is the woman that I posted on Facebook about this week. She is actually one of the BBC governors. I thought she was just a money launderer out of Finchley Road, as Gordon Bowden had described her as. But she is massive. She has a huge board. She's on the board at Centrica with Stephen Hester and Lady, my enemy in Greenwich, Baroness Blackstone. And Blackstone, as you now know, in one of the hundreds of videos that I've made, is just a massive financial institution in the USA. Yeah, all of them are out there now. Yeah. And all of the world is run like Hillary and Donald would like us to have it run. No leadership, no integrity, and there is Cameron peeking over the shoulder of Rebecca when they're alleged to have the love affair, and that is the LOL joke of why the lodges in Germany and Britain took us to war in World War II, because LOL is the names of the lodges that meant that King George VI was the stammering king in the speech and in the Hollywood Oscar winning movies. Right then, let me get you now to Kate Irving's boards, and we'll start at the top. If we went to the bottom, we would find David Steele, because that's the way I've done it. He's at the bottom of the listing, but because I found him there, I want to show you what also is on their boards. They've got on it a company called Campania, and that is the joke about the region in Italy that the Bible was launched from, and it has now become a pornography cover. Okay, and the name Quervain is on these boards, and Quervain gets you 5,860 results on fucky buddy, fuck buddy, tickled pea torture, cum choke gag pics, make a sex toys cronio, playboy cum shot espresso bar, erotic Pompeii sideshows reservoirs, video de Quervain thumb. The Quervain affliction in medicine is the capacity not to be able to move your thumb, yeah, like the emperor did. Yeah, it's ever so funny. Yeah, that is the Gladiator movie where the emperor called the emperor's enemy, called Maximus, is actually the Pizzo assassin in Naples when Vesuvius erupted. Yeah, and that's why the erotic cover-ups are all over this. Every time you see the word Campania and their company, you get the name of someone who lived in that town all those years ago. Yet with a tiny little derivation, like I told you about for the Getty family the other day. The Getty family and Arius Calpurnius Piso live in villas called the Villa Papyri. 2,000 years apart, but all part of the same big dick is beautiful joke. Yeah, that's the fish in the Bible. Brunette sucks dick de Quervain's thumb spiker. Yeah, quite crude, but let's just take you through the financial services and false news empire that is Kate Irvin's. Eleanor Kate Irvin. Could be Andy Irvin's Mrs., but I doubt it. Yeah, no way of knowing because of, and there we got enjoy raunchy lesbian fuck bronze designs, the queer vein, or blowjob online, Pompey erotic graffiti. Yeah, they will do anything they can to cover the Bible story. Yeah, and here we're now into the company directors for their queer veins directorate. Yeah, and here we've got Abogado Nominees Limited, and Eleanor Kate Irving's director number is 918-503-725. She has 1,800 interlocks, 1,800, all of them false news people. The Welshman you saw is on the board. There is Baroness Margaret Ann G, the Levison Inquiry Inquisitor is pictured below. Okay, Colina Jane Reed, that is likely to be Lord Reed of Celtic, Baron Reed of Celtic. And now we've got down to the laundering vents. There are 47 pages for administrators and 180 pages of directors. Avogadro Nominees, Combined Secretarial Services, Crosswall Nominees Limited, and 47 times 10, that's almost 500 administrators, like Eleanor Kate Irving. Yeah, every one of them will have up to 2,000 interlocks. Yeah, it's a massive spider's web of fraud, and every one of those is able to release the news that you watch every night. Yeah, and some of the members of the boards quite shocked me. Bob Geldof's on it, and you should see his ID so that no one can find him out. This could be Piers Morgan, but his real name is Viscount Piers James Hampden Inskip Caldicott, ITV News Channel Limited, Broad Street Films Limited, Carlton 96, Carlton 40 Investments. All of the Ponzi shelves, all of the money laundering vents that they need are there. Vistra Nominees Limited, Columbia TriStar, Carlton Productions Limited, York Place Nominees Limited, one of the biggest laundering companies, and that's a director, not on the admin team. Yet we're on page 186. Yet, so it's actually over 1,800. It's 1,870 pages. 70 directors. Okay? And there you can see more clearly Eleanor Kate Irving's moniker, and there is the links to all of the other tabs there. It starts off with links to scams that are involved in treating cancer, yeah, and that's why the page is called Cancer Drugs. But when you get down to the wows, Buck and Bland, wow, Notting Hill, wow, Lord Hollick of Notting Hill, Clive Richard Hollick of Notting Hill, Centrica, Rabats, yeah, and the BBC directors, the interlock with the ITV leaders, yeah, it's absolutely sickening. And that's why there is no truth released into the world about what Geoffrey Archer actually does to become a billionaire. Okay, Lord Alan Lamb, Charles Lamb Allen, ITV Wales and West Group Limited. Right Honourable Lord David Steele of Aquid, ITV Borders Limited. Yeah, that is Callum Kerr's constituency, and there he is peeking over the TV camera's lens. That presumably is his daughter. That is Aquid, where he runs the NHS scams out of his garage. And I've got the pictures of that on that other computer over there in the wilderness in my new location. Okay, and he's into the charitable scams as well. The people in the wheelchairs all around them. The launch of the Olympic Games and the Paralympic Games scandal that I told you about on the weekend with Princess Anne. Yeah, running Rolls Royces out of Aquid for a laugh. Okay, and let's keep going down. There he is in the, that is the session court where we went last week, and the ordinary people are not allowed to make law claims against the corrupted government of Scotland, and everything that I've reported to that corrupted government, and even more to Westminster, has been totally ignored, and it's now becoming the Hillary Clinton, because I'm lobbying her as well, and all of my emails have gone to her over 5 years already, and my Skype communications still go to her. Yeah, she never replies on Skype. Yeah, but they confirmed the receipts on all of the emails I have sent to that woman through all of the time. And you can see the power base here. He's Osborne, who's been chased from office because he interlocks with the Future of Russia Foundation, Henry Kissinger, and the Rothschilds, and the Royal Prince. Yeah, there is Steele in his younger days, and that is Salmond. Yeah, the traitor to his country, in inverted commas, because his country is Frankfurt's Germania and Austria's master race land. Yeah, Alex Salomon Rothschild. The Honourable Antoinette Sarah Frances Sybil Morrison. The Honourable Antoinette Sarah Frances Sybil Morrison. Carlton Broadcasting Limited. And a different one of Carlton Broadcasting Limited's, page 8184. This is the Welsh rugby star, the Honourable Jonathan Hugh Davis, the controversial rugby league player who scored a simple try against my mate Andrew Kerr, who plays for Watsonians but was not at the club on the weekend when they were defeated by Andy Irving's Heriots. ITV Wales and West Group. Do you see how they do it? They slot them into the local regions so they become even bigger heroes than David Steele was for me when I was a boy. And he's very reluctant to meet me now and never talks. I met him at the horsey events run by the Duke of Roxburgh, and he tried to have a conversation, but he's ever so nervous because I've got every one of his links to the Future of Syria Fund with Ian Fleming. The Honourable Sarah Jane Lawson, Anglia Television. The Lord Allen of KE, Charles Lamb Allen, Grenada. Yeah, whether or not that is his local region, and whether that is a tax haven. But there is Jonathan Davis, Jiffy, as they nickname him. He's in the global game thief thing, because he was rugby league, he was rugby union, he was British Lion, and he is now sucking in the money from his directorates in the false news sector and from everything that he does that earns him a salary for the BBC or whoever covers rugby nowadays. Yeah, it flits around all of the time. And there's the Quervain directorate of Pompey. Right then, so Sir Charles Andrew Morrison, 25th June 1932 to 2005, he was a British landowner and Conservative politician. He sat as a Member of Parliament for Devizes, where NATO's armies were after him sent to war by Michael Ancram, Lord Lothian, the Marquess of Lothian. Morrison's great-great-grandfather, James Morrison, created the family's grand fortune by stockpiling fascist black crepe fabric in readiness for the mourning of King William IV in 1837. That is William IV, that is the relative of either Cameron or Boris Johnson, I can't remember. Yeah, and all of the Freemasonic German kings who were the sons, yeah, and led to the stammering King George VI being the leading Freemason when he made the stammering speech. Yeah, that's the Master Masons of our country, all out of Hanover. We've never had an English king or queen in Britain, yeah, since Guillaume nipped across the channel, yeah, in Baroness Blackstone's region, right next to Greenwich. Woman of the bedchamber to Queen Elizabeth II, that's the Morrisons of the supermarket fame too. Okay, the Honourable Antoinette Sarah Frances Sybil Morrison. And here we've got the Honourable Sam Antoinette Sybil Francis. Wait for it. Yeah, she's not as innocent as the Antoinette woman who got her head lopped off, allegedly. Total lies, every one of them. Vice President Emeritus, World Wildlife Fund for Nature, born 1934, London. Parents, Count Viscount Wraxall of Wraxall, Long of Wraxall, Laura Duchess of Marlborough, that is Winston Churchill's sectarian gift for the Orange Wars, married Honourable Charles Andrew Morrison, languages French, political career, Wiltshire County, professional career, General Electric Company, the biggest in America, non-executive director, Abbey National PLC, Carlton TV, Kleinwort Charter Trust, Chinese National Council for Voluntary Organizations, formerly National Council of Social Service. Yeah, you can see entrepreneurial all the way to the bank and all the way to the news release about the false stuff about Geoffrey Archer. Images for Honourable Antoinette Morrison. Yeah. Public International Law, International Yearbook and Statements, who's who? Yeah, all of them, massive celebs, but Lord Hollick looks ever so decrepit. And that was made way back years ago. His empire is just as big as Eleanor Kate Irvin's. She's just the administrator with most numbers on our boards. The Honourable Mrs. Antoinette Sarah. Oh, let's get going down, because I've a long way to go. And my camera from Kodak in Hemel Hempstead is beginning to fail me. Okay, Coleman's on Anglia Television. Arculus, and there is Sybil Morrison again. The goddess Sibel joke for Naples. Sir Paul Douglas Nicholson's. These are the world-owning Nicholson families of Musselburgh, strangely enough. Yeah, my old boss. Yeah, the woman's from Bristol, the husband's from Musselburgh, where the earliest golf course and race course are. They're the folk that chased me out of New Zealand. Yeah, as the leader of the best department, which she was the dean for. Yeah. Yeah, and there's the Ellisons of the rich list. Yorkshire Tyne Tees linkages. Sir Ralph Harry Carr Ellison. Yeah, Harold Ellison is my mate from Blackpool, and Ellison is the Forbes rich list member. Sir Gerard Jude Robinson Granada. Sir Judson Graham Day ITV Meridian. Sir Lawrence Woodward Martin Tyne Tees. Yeah, must be a Jadi or Mackim. Sir Leo Pliatz, do you get it? How they cover up all of the truths for the region. Sir Michael Thomas Lyons, ITV Central. Sir Patrick Dalmahoy, Nairn, I cannot suss that one out. This is page 182, I'd better get a move on. Patrick Nairn, okay, highlighted. Permanent Secretary of the Department of Health and Social Security and Master of St Catherine's College, Oxford. Nairn was a Privy Council member, appointed in 1982 when he became a member of Lord Franks's official inquiry into the Falklands War, and the gotcha headline for Rupert Murdoch on the Sun. But that is not a TV company, so we'll move back to the Ditchley Foundation. He was Chancellor of the University of Essex, where Prem Sikka, my mate, works, and he's still my Facebook friend, Prem, one of the world's ordinary loyal accountants. He tries to solve the frauds, but not at the national level, at a very, very local level. Yeah, he, and that's the Premslids of Austria. He was an honorary fellow of University College Oxford. Nairn was the first chair of the Nuffield Council on Bioethics, and that is the Nuffield linkages to drug supply and all of the medical issues in our country. Patrick Nairn was the father of Sandy Nairn, director of the National Portrait Gallery. Yeah, the interlocks to the piss artist sector, all of them have it. All of it is a money stream, every one of those strands. Sergeants in Nominees Limited, Sir David Austin Trippier, Sir Derek Palmer, Sir Francis Christopher Buchan Bland. That's one of the other wow tabs. His boards and his interlocks are just as big as Hollick's and Michael Grade's and this woman's. Miss Teresa Mary Margaret Jones, Tiffany Fernbrill, Tracy Ann MacLeod, Vivian Coleman, they're Granada, those ones. Professor John Owen Williams, he's ITV Wales, as the name suggests, and I thought it may be my hero who was J.P. Williams, the Welsh fullback, who was a student at Imperial College London, and he played on the flank in the scrum on a Wednesday, so he could make himself a hard man, and he was a really gifted rugby player, and he is a gifted medic. I don't think this is the same one. I tried to find him, and I found the pictures. It's not John Williams, the rugby player. They look really crusty and decrepit compared to him. Yeah, he may be the most innocent rugby player in that Welsh team. The others fish the junction pool. Yeah, and it's just amazing. And they are interlocked to all of those people that are the jokers called Chris Tarrant. Yeah, and that is the Tarantella out of Naples joke too. Okay, Reed Services Limited, Reverend Peter Cedric Moth, Tyne Tees, Geordie or Macam. Right Honourable David Thomas Griffith Baron Evans of Clochton, page 180. Let's get a move on. Tiffany Brill, Theresa Mary Margaret Jones, Vivian Coleman, Reed Services, Right Honourable David Thomas Griffith Baron Evans of Clochton on Grenada. Stacey Lee Cartwright, Susan Jan Johnston, Susan Janet Robertson, Susan Macy, Susan Margaret Elliott. Yeah, this is the Elliots that are the people that are the Douglas family lineage and live on the Springwood estate and trade bulbs with the Dutch people, that is the Springwood estate for FDR from Holland in America, in Pearl Harbor, and all of those vents for all of the jokes about false religion. Okay, Tanya Shillingford, next page, Bredman Birdseye, and there, Campania. Do you get it? That is the Campania Birdseye jokes, and every one of them you can find the Birdseye linkage. So that is fish fingers, yeah, and the fish in the Bible is the penis, and the finger in the joke is also up the pie pisofani Campania. Yeah, only a few directors, but they always need to laugh at everything they do. Sarah Elizabeth Birdseye is also on ITC this something, and let me see if I can see what it is. ITC distribution. Yeah, that'll be an independent television company. Sarah Jane Gregson, Select TV Cable. Sarah Louise Brookings, yeah, that's the Brookings Institute cover in America for the Secret Society. Carlton Food Network, Carlton Entertainment. Stacey Lee Cartwright, let's get a move on. I'm never going to get there. I think I should do pictures only. Yeah, let's. Okay, there's Campania. Yeah, do you get it? The company that is the news event, and they are still releasing the news like the Pizzo family did about how the Bible was totally defrauded. The whole of the story was written by them in that key period from 55 to BC, or even 120 BC, when they were already, as the Pizzo Frugis, running the mint. Okay, so Campania, carry on camping, yeah, for Frankie Howard and the Jokers. Okay, and here we've got Lewis Patricia Golding, Lorraine Alana Ellicott, Louise Butting, Lucinda Mary Williams, Maudsley Fay, Mary Elizabeth Glanville. Yeah, nothing of note. Stross Worrell, yeah, that's the Worrells of my town. Every time I mention the Polish camps, Cliff Worrell comes forward and looks sheepish in the, and he is a registered person, or she, Kathleen Avril Marley Worrell, is in the ITV Borders region that Cliff Worrell lives in, and he was a rugby playing mate of mine, and he still talks to me, and he's a decent kind of bloke. I don't know why he's embarrassed by the death camps in Poland. Catherine Elizabeth Smith, Glotzer Mullins. Yeah, that's the Mullinses of the horse racing empire, and the man who was sectioned by Rothschild, yeah, which is why they launched the Mullins to win the Grand National. Anthony Worrell Thompson. Yeah, there he is. Famous face. Let's see what he does. So he is, what does it say about him? This is published by the Mirror in Britain. And there is, so he's, the Worrell is on the board. And that is just a comedian, I think, the guy that we've seen the picture of. Catherine Rebecca Little, and page after page of Stross. She's on London Weekend, Granada, Music Services, Tyne Tees. Yeah, she's a globalised presence. Like the people who were named, and they are on the Mayflower. Emmeline Clare, Mary Clare Williamson, London Weekend, Gabriel Mary Williams, Geraldine Woods, Calcy, Helen Andrews, Helen Brown Stevens, Helen Jane Tots. That's another wow one. She has page after page after page. Here we've got the Caymans Islands tax havens. Yeah, one of the, there it is. Okay, Helen Jane Tots, ITV Holdings, Cayman Limited. Okay, five-story Cayman Islands building that 18,857 companies call home. Tax haven for the rich. Yeah, this is tax haven for the poor. BBC companies, ITV, independent television. Tax havens by name, that's all of the landlocked ones now, since Delaware, the De La Warren jokes. Yeah, for the rabbit empire. Grand Cayman. Okay, and there we have, take it back to the Greek civilization. Okay, everything is a massive fraud, including, yeah, the pornography in Quervain's Pompeii. And here we've got a scandal in the making. This one's an MP, Catherine Margaret Mary Maxwell Stewart. She was the MP for Peebles, yeah, in 2000, I think. Yeah, and she is a relative of the Stuart claimants to the throne from the estates that I've worked on. Yeah, pictures of that further down. Here she is. Yeah, this will be really embarrassing for you, Callum Kerr, unless you let me have that meeting soon. Yeah, he's from the town of Peebles and the current incumbent in David Steele's position as my local MP for Westminster. Catherine Margaret Mary Maxwell Stewart. Total number of appointments, 14. Tweedale Youth Action, Old Corn Exchange, Newbury Court, Schoolbury, Peebles, Scotland. And she is an estate owner. Yeah, she is the aristocracy that is Catherine Maxwell Stewart MP at the gates of Traquair House near Peebles. That is where all of the Stewart Mary Queen of Scots was taken from there and executed, and the names of all of her interlocks, yeah, are still the same. Yeah, that is the people that were my school friends out of Melrose. I forget the names. Lady Laird has hope, Labour hopes. So they're socialist politicians. My new man is an SNP politician. Yeah, even in Westminster. Now, that's how stupid the whole of the carving up and subsidiarising of politics has become. Lady of Traquair goes into battle, Scotland's only woman. Yeah. MP's plan for Scotland to be anti-capitalist territory. Yeah, this is, yeah, the biggest castle, and I used to work there as a fishing gilly for my mate from Freemasonic Selkirk, Bill Drew, for 60 quid a day. He's a kind of nice guy. Here we've got the Bradfords of the Mayflower. They have dozens, maybe even up to 30 pages all to themselves. Miss is Rachel Julia Bradford. That is the bosses on the Mayflower. London Weekend Television Productions, Anglia, ITV Studios, VOD member, and we've moved to a Jones, Sandra Elizabeth Valerie's Jones, kind of sinister name, yeah, because of my ex-wife's role in this ITV Wales and West. Yeah, do you get the Joneses? That could be the opera singer. Bridget. Sarah Gill. Sarah Louise Woodall. Sarah Louise Woodall. Okay, do you get it? The MPs of the year 2000, when I was just preparing to go to New Zealand with my innocent family, and this is what you get when you look for this quite unique name, Sandra Elizabeth Valerie Jones, on the internet. One image, two images, three images, four images, five images, six images, and they're co-educational schools in some, and they are women-only schools in other. She is a deep secret, and she's on the Welsh TV news boards. No one's allowed to know why or who she is or what she's done. There's the Bradford woman with a whole page to herself. We're now on to page 166. There's Rachel Julia Bradford Mayflower lists. You can get the Plymouth Plantation William Bradford, Billy Bradford, who was under the deck of that when they sailed out of Plymouth. Yeah, Pie Plymouth. From Naples, then from Holland, then into the boat, and there she is with another page. Planet 24, Granada, ITV News, VOD member, London, Tyne Tees. She's not a local person like David Steele, with only one directorate. Yeah, and that is now Global Christianity. And there's another page with her. And there's another page with her, just to emphasise that I'm not bullshitting you. We're now down to page 163. There's another one. 160. There's another one. 158. Oh, and we've got a Durkan. Phoebe Mary David, Yorkshire Television. Oh, and Rachel Julia Bradford again. Helen Jane Tots. Yeah, the massive links. Yeah, this is one of the biggest ones too. Okay, took me to 2 o'clock in the morning the other day to get to the bottom of the list. Yeah, there's Helen Jane Tots again. Carlton Central, ITV Global, Link Electric, Eleanor K. Irving. Page 143. Eleanor K. Irving. Rollison. Jane Clark, Catherine Alice Cleland, Claire Morrow, Parker, Eleanor K. Irving, Mr. William John Medlicott, Yorkshire, Wales, Granada, Tyne Tees, London, ITV, yeah, all over. They may be the presenters of the news, for all I know. Vernon John Lawrence, Peter Rogers, William C. Francis, Thomas Betts, Cole Reardon, Wellers of the pop singing lineages, Terence Paul George, Thomas David Sheriff, Reams Davis, Matthew Betts, the Earl of Dalkeith. Yeah, they're really difficult to track down. That is the Douglas family again, and it could be any of those people. Yeah, at least they've not got their school chums with them. Yeah, let's see why the Earl of Dalkeith is listed on this board. Stuart Till, Peter Purvis, you remember the TV presenter on Blue Peter? Stuart Mainwood, Stuart Richard Thomas, Sidney Perry, so I have not got the Duke, Earl of Dalkeith there. Oh, there he is, Mr. the Earl of Dalkeith, ITV, and he is on the Borders one. Yeah, because Dalkeith is just to the north of the Borders. Okay, and you've got Betts, Davis, ITV Wales. Every time it's a Davis, it's ITV Wales. And there is the Earl of Dalkeith. Yeah, massive linkages. Look at my Facebook page and scan down until you find the references to the massive Fred Olsen shipping companies run by the Earls of Dalkeith and the Douglases and the Mortons and all of the LinkedIn names. So Peter Purvis of Blue Peter. Campania, yeah, and the till's name, it links you to Campania. And there is Stephen Shaw, Butterfields, whole pages of Butterfields. And I've told you about the Butterfields of Hexham, who were friends of my wife, and their correspondence about how guilty they were about how they treated their friends in the south. Stephen Edward Hewlett, Hargreaves Hall, Stephen Ireland, Stephen J. Sheffer, Stephen Ralph Platt, Simon Shapps. Do you remember the cabinet minister called Grant Shapps? Yes. And I believe that was the name of the relatives of my wife's family that were the money launderers of Watford. Yeah, and he lives in Germany now. He's my Facebook friend for 2 or 3 years, and we went to his wedding in Watford. Simon Albury, there's a Hewlett. Yeah, Stephen Edward Hewlett. Albury, Carlton, Cox, Johnson, Heller, Simon Peter Edmund, Cosmo William Townley, Simon Shapps again, Granada and ITV Sports Channel, page 120. Keep going quickly. There is Simon Shapps at ITV. Yeah, quite a casual looking man. Don't know how much they get for every one of the 1,860 directors. There is Piers Morgan. He may be that man with that heavily hyphenated name. And he's just the cover for Longshanks' son's lover, Dilnot Cooper. Rupert Michael Walter James Dilnot Cooper. Simon Freyer Scott, Sean Carl Taylor, Thomas Hancock, Miss Valerie Jane, Roger Thomas, Action Time Holdings, Roland John Brown, Ronald Arthur Eagle, Daniel Miller, Dodds Henwoods, Roderick Walderman, Lille Henwoods. These are not just ordinary Joes. Very well connected. Roger Charles Lewis, Roger David Eckford Leward, Roger Derek James, that's Eckford, where my sister's first lover comes from. Roger Dickinson, and the relatives of Butcher Haig are still in Eckford. Richard Philip Middleton, Richard Scales Myers, that is the Myers of Frankfurt. Yeah, that is the spy who shagged me jokes for the Rothschilds. Robert Alan Schmitz. Yeah, and he pretends he's a rustic West Country man, the Myers on this board. Here we go. Robert Frederick Zenon Geldof, Z Music Publishing Company, Planet 24 or something, Planet 24 Productions. And when you look at his picture now, he's so old and crusty that he could well be one of those extraterrestrial invaders. Yeah, Mr. Robert George McGee, Pickwick Packaging Limited. Yeah, right into the Shakespearean jokes, and you've got to pick a pocket or two. There is Robert Frederick Zenon Geldof. Yeah, at Rupert Murdoch's wedding to the hall woman. Yeah, all of them look as if they are on the verge of death's door, and his daughter was alleged to have died. Yeah, probably to cover up things like "we know it's Christmas" joke. Yeah, and the Biafran genocide that they starve everybody for so they can raise the charitable funding like the cancer drugs companies. All acts of God and the afflictions of the cancers. Robert Frederick Zenon Geldof, Rupert Murdoch wedding. There he is. There is he cuddling Tony Blair, the genocidal leader. There is, that could be Elizabeth Murdoch. Yeah, looking very, very lean. There is, yeah, there is the wife of this man. who was the Rolling Stones singer's Mick Jagger, his wife was at the wedding. Mick Jagger is in the team all the way through Geldof Rupert Murdoch wedding. Another set of images. There's Geldof, and that is his wife, and that I believe is the wife of the man we've just shown you of the Rolling Stones. There's the pair that get married, effectively the world's owner now. Yeah, the biggest press empire in the world, Fox News and everything that the cock crows at in the Jesus story. That is, yeah, Patty News, yeah, and everything that we've got with the Getty images takes you right back to Naples too. Okay, Gove was there, he's not in those images. Okay, and that is the actor that was on the Scottish News, the composer that was the man that made all of the musicals about Odessa, yeah, and the Odessa file. And do they know it's Christmas? I forget what the Christmas joke is for Odessa and that film about the Nazis. Okay, Pompey Studio says it can survive the film's disastrous box office, and this is the Constantine link to one of the directors that we've got further down. Pompey Film, Constantine Don Carmody Film Productions, box office 118 million. German Canadian American 3D historical disaster romance film, a new one about Pompeii in 2014, made by Constantine Film Companies, because Emperor Constantine was in the Piso team that launched the Bible. And I don't know what it's got to do with the directorial links, but hopefully we'll see it here. Yeah, Mr. Richard Michael Constant, ITC Distribution. Okay. Yeah, massive. Every one of the boardrooms. We're now on page 113. Howell, Jonathan Harris, McNally, Peter Joseph, that's Peter Graham Howell, Mr. Peter Lucas, Carlton Films, Mr. Peter Mitchell, Mr. Peter Robin Paxton, that's the Paxtons that were the Rothschilds' architects before Bomber Harris brought down their mansions. Peter Brownlow, Hickson, another mayor, Peter David Mayer, United Broadcasting and Entertainment Limited, the spy who shagged me. Mr. Peter Frank Johnson, Planet 24, Mr. Peter Fullwood Booth, Mr. Peter Graham Howell. Let's go till we see another picture. Oh no, there's a Brooks. Paul Anthony, Planet Wild Productions with Bob Geldof, Planet 24 Productions with Bob Geldof. Yeah, does not get more evil. That is the Brookses of the Innsbruck region. Yeah, there's John Arney, Paul Cusick, Nigel Bray, Lithgow, Walmsley, Nicholas Castro, Yorkshire TV Limited, more localised than you would imagine from the name. Nicholas Elliott, Nicholas Francis Markham. There's Castro for real, if he's not just an actor. Yeah, that one of the last central banks in Cuba to go to Rothschild. Okay, sorry, I've hit the wrong. Okay, there is Lord Markham of Ukraine, and you find nothing on him because he's a massive propaganda presence in Ukraine, a multi-billionaire, and only me talks about such things. Yeah, that's the Etonian banker, and that is my mate Nathan Rothschild, who's in my hometown and has the capacity for greatness. Yeah, there's all of the stuff that I've released, and that is not the one who I introduced at the beginning of the video, but that is Hannah Mary Rothschild's favourite man. Yeah, because of his political astuteness. Project Focus update, sciences. So Tony Markham, yeah, pictured there, if that is him. It does not look very like him to me, but there was no images of Tony Markham when I searched for him. Okay, and this is quite, yeah, Tony Markham was my colleague at the pharmacy school in Sunderland, and Peter Fidler and David Puttnam were his bosses, and Tony Shagham in the toilets Markham is a legend for a womaniser. Yeah, and this is the covers that Sunderland University launched all of those massive jokes through Puttnam's news events and the Puttnam Weekly and the Puttnam Monthly, which is the Know Nothings joke in America, and the Notting Hill movie that Lord Hollick of Notting Hill is also part of. And this one lectured to me in New Zealand. Yet he travels the world, and he's the cover for Winston Churchill being one of the world's biggest killers. Used to wear Union Jack underpants, and when Sunderland was upgrading its portfolio, he came there and defended all of that, and Sunderland was first class because Lord David Puttnam, who's on this list, is part of the propaganda team globally. That's why he gets to lecture at the Hay Book Festival with Hannah Mary Rothschild, and that's why he goes to Auckland to lecture. Yeah, and I've seen him all around the world, and he is just a petty comedian. There's Mr. Nicholas Castro, Millbank Television, Mr. Nicholas Castro TV, Tyne Tees, Yorkshire Tyne Tees, Yorkshire Tyne Tees again, Tyne Tees Television. Six or seven there, all in a row, next to Bingham, Columbia TriStar, Carlton Productions. We're on page 100. Let's get a move on. And I've got on 51 minutes, so it's got to be pictures only. There's Clark's Bests, Michael Green. This is the stuff about Peter Philip Green. So when you look for Michael Philip Green, you get Peter Green now. That is all of the British Home Stores scandal. Michael Green is a media magnate. There he is, pictured there. But when you look it up, it is Peter Green and all of the massive retail frauds. Yet they cover the news all of the time and cover the fact that my mate John Patterson is Peter Green on Facebook. Everything is an obfuscation tool. Mr. Michael Melvin Fagan. You get that one? Yeah, in the Zionist medias, and we've not gone to Tel Aviv yet, but we will in a minute. Yeah, 7 or 8 for Fagan, ITV Wales, Yorkshire TV, Granada, Tyne Tees, Michael Myers again, First Independence for Alex Salomon Rothschild, Broadcasting Empires, Mr. Michael Philip Green, Carlton. There he is. Yeah, that is the legendary Fagan in the movie, and that is his links to Sir Richard Sykes, my old boss at Imperial College London, before Lord Kerifkin Lockhart and Lady Manningham Buller of MI5. Yeah, and all of the Intel professoriat took over and began to shaft every British student by feeing them, taking from them pocket or two's worth of £70,000 for the 4-year honours degree that me and Sir Richard Sykes of Welcome, my boss at Welcome, my pension is totally fucked because of him now. Yeah, Sir Richard Sykes and Bill Fagan above. Okay, Michael John Desmond, John Hughes, pictures only. Okay, Rosenberg, oh, that's the Austrian nobility, what a shame. Rosenberg, Austrian nobility, and all of the balls. Yeah, and that is all of the jokes about the Sound of Music and the Austrian nobility still being the world owners, although they're not allowed to use their titles. Mervyn John Warner. And here we've got Melvin Bragg. Wadham Alumni Bragg, no images available, with Chief Statistician Lord Klaus Moser at the Wadham College in Oxford that they both went to. And there's Moser himself, the chief statistician for our country. I don't know whether or not Bragg, and there's the Warner Brothers logo. So Burrell, 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 David Myers, Baker. So Melvin must be above. Sorry, I missed it. Do you get it? That is his links as a broadcaster through all of my life. There he is. London Weekend Television Productions, ITV Borders, because he's a Cumbrian like blind Prince George of Cumbria and Teviotdale, that was the only true legitimate lover of Queen Victoria, who had their baby in Carlisle Castle. which is why he's an ITV Borders magnet, and we even listened to him speaking in English when I was in fucking honeymoon in fascist Norway. Yeah, you know the bunny jokes now, and Bugs is in this too. Burrell, Broughton, Miller, Myerses, Mr. Martin John Baker. Several newsreaders called Baker for obfuscation tools. Charlton's Zoo Sam, Columbia TriStar, Rittner, no pictures, here we've got one. Ludwig Wilhelm, Prince Zuzalm Salm. Better check that he's not on the boards above. Well, he is. So he's Ludwig Wilhelm Prince Zuzalm Salm, Columbia TriStar, Carlton Productions, right next to a Ritter and a Charlton. Yeah, and this is his genealogical page, and he's from Hamburg. Nicholas First Zoom Sam, and that's all we're allowed to know. There's nothing on him. Yeah, I think he's dead now. No pictures, and there's a Burns, and no pictures. And there is the links to one of those names, and the. Oh no, this is just a profiling of them. Haimovitz, Nick Jonas, I don't know what that is. Oh, so it's Haimovitz is the name I'm looking for. And they are also, because they're on the Campania boards, out of Pompeii. This time, blessedly, not out of the pornography sector. Right then, pictures. Bonner Howards, yeah, massive names. John Douglas Surtees, that is the joke that Lord Hollick's empire originated from the Isle of Man, and the TT is two of the three Christian crosses. Okay, John Douglas Surtees, Provision, Film Lab. No pictures. Here we've got O'Brien's, and this is another one of the Pompeys. This time it's Cresswell on the boards, and they are also all over the Pompeii and Herculaneum news. Not always historic characters, sometimes archaeologists, yeah, and sometimes the Getty Images fraud. Okay, here's the Sutherlands of sending the colonists to the colonies on the ITV Borders board because they're in Merton. Mr. John Alexander Muir Sutherland, when you try and find a picture of the Mertons and the Duchess of Sutherland and her relatives, you cannot find anybody. It's like finding those pictures of the classroom again. No hits Sutherland of Merton, ever so evasive, but they're in the Borders TV region. Okay, pictures. Yeah, we're now, I don't know what page, Johannes Cornelius Maria von Galen, director from London. And all of it is the company pages that they were on, Pickwick Packaging Limited. Yeah. And it tells you the Kidwells have dozens. And Tibbetts, Lancaster, oh no pictures. Sorry, I must not sin. Here's the one that we started with. Okay. Hugh Humphreys Davis. There he is. Yeah, talking about Lady Archer. Lord Archer, yeah, and the billionaire issues that do not include his sexual life. Yeah, he's on the fucking board. Humphrey John Barclay, London Weekend Television. Hugh Humphreys Davis, ITV Wales and West, now reading the global news, yeah, from that front chair at the BBC that I watch at the pub every night. Last night we were diverted by Celtic. Yeah. Parsons on the board, like Nicholas, yeah, and there is Greg Dyke. He is on the board with that woman who is Heather Rabatz at the Football Association. Gregory Dyke, London Weekend Television. Gregory Dyke, London something N, Yorkshire Time Tees Television. Yeah, right next to the Parsons. Nicholas was in one. I think he is an interlock to the Duke of Roxburgh, or he is an interlock even to Longshanks. I can't remember. And so, Gwyn Edward Ward Thomas, and so you've got the Welsh newsreader that we've just seen introducing the massive sexual scandals of the billionaires in our country, and he's on the board. Nobody's allowed to know how much they get for this. Yeah, this is the one that I've just told you about, that is the massive magnet for television in Britain. Greg Dyke, London Weekend Television, he was the big boss, like that woman that I only learned about, Heather Rabatz, this week. And you should see her interlocks in the power brokers that are Stephen Hester, and all of the massive, and there's the parrot joke. Yeah, I don't get that yet. It's in the Monty Python's jokes. It's in everything that the false Christianity laughs at. It could just be the Pirates of the Caribbean, yeah, and the parrot being on their shoulder as the global financial piracy continues. Pictures only. There we have Eamon Andrews. Yeah, let's just keep going on the boards. Yeah. Pictures only. ITV Israel. Where is that? Yeah, that's Shimon Peres and Obama talking in the Knesset, like Cameron. Yeah, and they are part of the ITV network. ITV Meridian, Carlton 99, ITV Studios, Israel Limited. That one. Okay, sorry about the quality. It's better in the pitch dark. Okay, that is the Frasers that sent me from the court, Procurator Fiscals, David Richard Frasers, Granada Film, Granada Television, and let's just watch the pictures. Right then, and there is the Israeli icons. Even Elizabeth Taylor was a Zionist, and that is the links to her neighbours in fucking Egypt. Yeah, and all of the films that they made about, yeah, about the lovers of Mark Antony and Julius Caesar in that regime down there. And here we've got Pompey members again. We've just passed a Zebedee production for False Religion. That's out of the Bible too. Yeah, the Fires of Pompey. What is the name we're looking for this time? Rodmail. Oh no, Hutchings. No, I'm not sure what the name is. Let's see if we can see it. There is Eamon Andrews every Christmas morning visiting the hospitals and the charities that they also profit from. We're on page 43 now. Might make it to the end. Let's go to the bottom first and come from the bottom back up to here. Yeah, because that's got loads of pictures at the bottom. Okay, and it's got items from the House of Commons, and all of the Parliament buildings' conflicts of interest are totally ignored. Geoffrey Archer scandal, okay? It's on the front page of every paper. They do not mention the scandals that make him a billionaire. Yeah, his wife is on this board. Okay, there is the Murdochs. Yeah, the commanders-in-chief and the woman from Chipping Norton that runs the whole of that Sky empire. Tory boss Archer pays off vice girl. There is G, the Levison Inquiry Inquisitor. Yeah, there is Baroness Margaret Ann G on the Carlton boards. Let's go quickly. There is the man that we've just been talking about and his wife. Yeah, he's the sexual billionaire criminal. Yeah, and she's on the board. No one knows how much she earns from that. Yeah, and that is Dame Maureen Doreen Archer, Anglia Television. Only one registration. Crosswall nominees have 9 or 10 above her. And now we get to the Alzheimer's and the boobs knocker Pompey for Quervain again. Yeah, we'll find him on the board now if we look closely. Yeah, this is the pornography in the cover, and it is also de Quervain's tenosynovitis, the thumb issue for the Roman Emperor, yeah, as they declare whether or not the gladiators, the slaves, have to be killed. Maximus, the Piso assassin, Eleanor K. Irving's directors, and there is Dr. Emile Hugh de Quervain of Naples on the Campania board. Can you see it just sticking its nose round the corner? Up we go. Right then. And only pictures. Only pictures until I finish the sad saga. Granada nominees, page after page. Instant Companies Limited. These are the laundering vents. Yet there are only number 450 for them. Idwal Eric Simmons, Granada Nominees Limited. Pictures, pictures, pictures. University Superannuation Scheme. Yet find a woman that's in charge of that. That has already been cut into by my wife, totally for profiteering reasons. Yeah, and I've not been able to see it because I've not got access to my documents. Work history, yeah, and they could be burning them, yeah, they could be destroying all of my chattels. She's unprepared to insure it in the house that they forcibly arrested me from, then chucked me out on the pavement. I've paid the insurance ever since she fulfilled the 2-year separation clause. Yet comprehensive insurance for rebuilding and all of my contents and hers inside, she's unprepared to pay. Lady Maureen Michael Merson, director from Bristol, was a renowned director at the ITV pension scheme and on the university's pension scheme. Lady Patricia Nutting, director at Wiltshire Historic Buildings. Lady Diane Nutting Anglia. Some of these are covers for the murder of the young Duke of Northumberland. Okay, this is Lady Diana Catherine Eccles, Baroness Eccles, the ecclesiastical joke at every opportunity. Biography for Baroness Eccles of Moulton, Baroness Eccles of Moulton, and there she is on the board, Time Tease TV. Royal Institute for International Affairs, Chatham House, Civil Aviation Authority. This is the one of the ones who is involved in the political roles at Westminster. And he's an ever so decrepit looking person. Full title, the Lord Tugendhat. Christopher Samuel Tugendhat joined the Lords 1993. Party group Conservative. There he is. Let me show you the picture at the top, and then let me show you his conflicts of interest that take you right into the Queen's welfare on the boards of everything that steal from our country. EU External Affairs Subcommittee, yeah, since May 2016. Yeah, not much of a future in that one. Oh no, sorry, that's the Economic Affairs Committee since May 2016. That's the only thing that counts. Lord Moser launders it out of the House of Lords, which he is in, and my former MP helps to launder it out of the House of Commons. Yeah, with loads of people like Nadeem Zahawi, if he's still in government. Okay, EU External Affairs Subcommittee, European Union Committee, 2013 to 2016. These are the people that have launched all of the false news. Member of the European Commission, 77 to 81. Massive money streams. Chairman, Abbey National, 1991 to 2002. Chairman, Blue Circle PLC, 1996 to 2001. No earnings declared. That was an obligation when I first came back in 2009. No conflicts of interest. Even although this bastard is chairman of the Royal Institute for International Affairs, or Chatham House, the Queen's Empire of Intel and Bank of England magnates that steal from the world, ever since 1986 to 1995, chairman of the Civil Aviation Authority right up to 1991. So we cannot blame him for the Heathrow shenanigans and all of the covers for Boris Johnson's activity and his links to the monarchy since Mad George III. Okay, do you get it? Lord Tugendhat, ever so Austrian noble, and he's on the World Wildlife Board too. Aubrey Buxton, obituary, TV, maybe it's Aubrey Buxton, that's on the wildlife board, and this is the cover for, this is Lady Naomi Buchanan, who's on the boards, and when you look her up, you get her. Yeah, quite a contrast to her. Yeah, and this is the cover for Naomi Campbell being the lover of the murdered, yeah, or the one who took an overdose, yeah, on the boards for these false news companies. Do you see the utility of it? No one can find the real Lady Naomi Buchanan, yeah, because Naomi takes you instantly into Naomi Campbell and the love life of the Duke of Northumberland, who was killed before the current one with Algernon in his middle names came to power and launched the poison garden with narcotics in it, because he overdosed on amphetamines. Lord John Eatwell. Let's just go through the pictures so I can show you exactly how the false news consumes everything that we watch at 6 o'clock. And Zebedee was on the news even earlier than that. John Eatwell, Baron Eatwell, Wikipedia, yeah, President of Queen's College Cambridge, a British economist, current President of Queen's, former senior advisor to the Labour Party, socialist again, ha ha. Here we've got a race going on, and a member of the judiciary, Lord John Tristram Oaksey. Yeah, and this is the joke about the world killing all of the troops in World War II and not being able to run for your country on a Sunday in the Olympics. Yeah, with Ian Fleming coming down and Mr. Bean being the war correspondent for Gallipoli. Chariots of Fire. This is the man who's on the board, David Puttnam, yeah, of Queensgate. And there is Lord John Eatwell, there's Puttnam of Queensgate. Bigger jokes against the war dead you cannot find anywhere in world history. Lord Clive Richard Hollick of Notting Hill, the know-nothing, yeah, who's involved in all of the running of the Isle of Man with the three-legged symbol for the yeah, the swastika without leg missing. Yeah, and the windmill jokes. Yeah, Notting Hill, the movie about what became the Levison inquiry, with all of their people on the same boards. In the corridors of power, David Lipsey. Yeah, there he is. Total twat with the briefcase and all of the cash in it. Lionel Robbins Lipsey, David Lipsey, Baron Lipsey. And here we've got a different one. This is Lord Hollick of Notting Hill. Yeah, and that's him defending the contracts that all went to Richard Branson because he lives in the tax havens and all of them launder through his vents. There is all of them lined up. Lord David Puttnam of Queensgate, Lord David Lawrence Lipsey, Lord Richard Hollick of Notting Hill. There's another one of Spycatcher. Whoa, we're into intel now. Robert Temple Armstrong, David Icke's official forums, Robert Lord Armstrong of Ilminster. Here we've got, oh, this one's a Lord Wahid Ali. Yeah, it could be the Islamic menace, but he's in the House of Lords, so he's okay. Right then, so here we've got Lord Ali. I was called sinful and dirty. Wahid Baron Ali, Croydon, London. Nationality British, political party Labour again, profession media entrepreneur. Yeah, now we have that confirmed. He's officially on all of the ITV boardrooms. Wahid Ali, 1964, is a British multi-millionaire media magnate. Yeah, do you get it? Do you see how they achieve that? And he's several registrations. Planet Wild with Geldof, Lord and I'm not sure what that one is. Zed Music Publishing, Planet 24 with Geldof, VOD member, Loveting Limited, the only Jew in the Scottish Borders, and she's in a terrible state the last time I saw her. That is not actually a director, which is a bit of a fraud in itself. Yeah, I don't understand it, but the Loveting Limited is listed as a directorial presence. Lord Robert Temple Armstrong of Ilminster. Pompey again. This time it's the Bugs Bunny joke. Okay, and that is the Bugs region in the death camps in Poland for the Warner Brothers and every one of the Muppet characters that accompanies the Christianity fraud out of that massive city, now a hub for pornography in the Mithraeum, even in those days of diamonds and dentistry. Pompey was all short train ride from Naples, and we alighted. We found ourselves confronted by a line of horse and buggies, all offering. Yeah, this is the buggy joke for the puttlockers and Puttioli is the joke about the Piso pen and the Bic pens, and they're all place names near Naples. Yeah, right through world history and right into these massive Zionist boardrooms. Yeah, it's not about Zionism, it's not about Christianity, it's about the money stream, and it could not be bigger. Alan Lewis Wolfson. Oh, pictures only. Alistair James Fletcher Much. Chowdhury. Yeah, I think that's the newsreaders themselves. No proof of that, that's speculation, I shouldn't do it. Okay, pictures of Lord Bernstein of Craigwheel, and that is another one of the bosses of the BBC, and that is the stuff that took me into Heather Rabat's Centrica, and all of the stories about the interlocks there. It's horrendous. Wow on every one of them under this tab, and I've not time to tell you about the cancer frauds. Mr. Alexander Lord Bernstein of Craigwheel and Granada Television. Alistair Stephen Tom, Miss Tom, of my wife's frauds against the innocent husband. David Abu, loads of them. Nigel Hopgood for the bunny jumpers. Yeah, and the bugs of Poland. And another Pompey joke. This time the name is Hutchings. Okay, do you get that one about the bunny rabbits and Winston Churchill and Lagos the rabbit of Macedonia, who's the ancestor of the person who was Alexander the Great in the Piso bloodline that takes you to Queen Elizabeth II, and all of it is out of pornography's Pompey. Yeah, that means that that one was on the Campania board. Yeah, it's not very subtle at all. Yeah, even John Parson will be able to follow the analysis of this. David George Hutchings. Yeah, the bunny joke for Winston Churchill, the world's biggest killer. And that is us back up to ITV Israel. I've finished my mission. Right, I'm going to stop there. Yeah, do you get it? Wow, Notting Hill. Wow, the Levison inquiry, convened and conducted by the Jays on this board, yeah, and convened and adjudicated over by Lord Levison Gower, who is related to the Duchess of Sutherland and is Levison Gower with vast tracts of land in Liverpool. I'm going to stop. Do you see it? Every night at 6 o'clock you are spoon-fed why you are poor, and a tiny number of the world leaders are filthy rich. Bye bye, and that is Anglia Television. And the director is Mr. David. Oh, where is the Tel Aviv bit? And we've seen, oh, there it is, ITV Studios Israel Limited. David Philip Magrena. Okay. Right above the Frasers that sent me as procurator fiscals from the borders into exile as the world's most innocent man. Okay, I will get them in the end. And eventually the light will penetrate through into the whole of this story. Bye bye. Okay.